You guys playing sheep here with round three, game one. I'm not gonna mulligan. This is probably the slowest hand I've ever had. Actually, you know what? Sounds crazy, but I'm playing against an Azorius deck. It's got the Azor's Elocutors I passed. I'm gonna mulligan. Oops. That was bad. I probably should have kept the first hand. I thought the risk was worth the reward here. Maybe that was a mistake. Okay, see, because I got a lot of two drops, so even having two mana is worth it in this deck, I think. What is that? Keening Apparition? Alright, so we're going Thrill Kill first then. So getting a mountain is going to be pretty key, I think, in this this matchup here. Doesn't attack. He might have stab wounds. I've definitely seen him play it. Don't want to play around it. Man, this is almost assuredly stab wound. Do I just play around it? Or do I force him to have it? I think I just force him to have it. I can see it. Swift Justice is coming. Yeah, Swift Justice is so coming. All right. I guess I could have just attacked with this guy and saw what happened. Might have been smarter than I would have kept my Thrill Kill here. I don't know. I mean, this isn't the greatest start, to be honest. Maybe I shouldn't have mulled. Ugh. That shuts down everything. Well, this is not going as well as I thought it would by mulliganing. Perhaps that was a loose, weak mulligan on my part. Yeah, I could probably have gotten there. So he's definitely going to block with the Keening. This guy's pretty useless, to be honest. Ugh, Seliver Songbirds just makes Rakdos Shred Freak look terrible. Mountain here is good. Now, I guess the question is, do I run out Cobble Brutes? I think I do. I run out the Brute here. He also has Knightly Valor, so that might just get thrown onto it, a Concordia Pegasus. Okay, and he has a Rogue's Passage too. He's gonna swing with the Concordia Pegasus and the bird. That's totally fine here. Rex Mahdi's good. I wouldn't mind actually running in with the team here. Reason being that I know I'm gonna trade something big, but like he's got three, well, two decent things coming his way. So I mean, if I just swing in with this, and this. I mean, he could do that and that, and I still have a Rage Mud on the field, which is not horrible. It's not an amazing trade. I mean, his best trades are that and that, right? And if he has pumps, then that sucks. But I gain some life, and then I have Rix Mahdi to follow it up with. So I'm not like maybe I don't run in with the Shred Freak. Oof. Okay, that sucks. That kind of sucks. I mean, I still got Rix Mahdi here, so that's not horrible. We are trading card for card here, which I guess is totally fine with the Rakdos way. Yeah, Spawn's gonna get in there, and we got a Gore House next turn. It's all right. What is this? Trustanis? Wow. He's got all the answers. He has all the answers. Maybe I should have. Fire is okay. Yeah, we're gonna do that here. Unfortunately, I can't leave up fire. That's okay. But I want to leave up fire for Knightly Valor, which is a probably going to happen in the next little bit. So, ooh, impact too. That's not bad. I might have to burn his Concordia Pegasus at some point. I really hope he tries to get greedy and puts like an enchantment on it. Because right now I'm not winning this race here. Although, let me think about this. I go down to 7. He goes down to 12, maybe. 12, 7, 4, 3, 2. So, I mean, I'm going to take it. I think I've got enough burn and reach here that as long as he doesn't have much more to offer. So, I guess the question is, do I start burning face now? Like, I could take him to 10. He might have Hustler Patrol, though. That would suck. So I have 3 more turns. I think I leave the burn up here. Yeah, I think we're just casting it now just to get a little bit more damage in. And if he's got removal, he's got removal. But we got to force the issue here a bit, I think. Ooh, that sucks. That really sucks. Okay. So now again, I go to 4. Ugh. It's not where I want to be at all. Yeah, this is getting ugly. Maybe I shouldn't have done a charge there. I could at least leave up Nihiling Fire. Now the question is, do I want Explosive Impact here? So it's either 4 or 5 damage that I go down to, which is not exciting at all, either one. I think it does decrease my clock enough, though, that I have to. And he dispels. Oh, that's a big dispel, too. Okay. So I know about that. I can't really play both. Well, I mean, I can go to 1 here, and that's not very exciting, to be honest. Yeah, I think I'm pretty dead here. I'm just going to see what else he has. That was a good dispel there, too. And the reason I played this Unleash is he has a Rogue's Passage. If he has a dude, I'm not blocking here. I go to 1. So I probably shouldn't have ran into that Swift Justice. That was a little loose on my part. Okay. So we're going to go to game 2. I'm going to be on the play. There's going to be Electricery after Electricery. Take out the Dynacharge. Take out... Man, this is a tight deck. Cobblebrute. Spawn, maybe Rage Mutt. Yeah, let's do that. I think the Electricaries are going to be pretty sick against him. He's got a lot of 1/1s, probably 2/1s or 3/1s, like all the flyers. Double Electricary is going to be good against him, I think. Yeah. And of course, we can always hope for the turn 2 Pack Rat. That'd be nice. Dispel, eh? That was a nice dispel against my... I probably would have let it go. Who cares? It's a 1/3. Whatever. All right. I would like to play first. This hand. Speak of the devil. I will not mulligan this because I'm going to play Pack Rat on turn 2. This is actually like a sweet hand in general. Made more sweet by the Pack Rat, obviously. Yeah, it's pretty dumb. Hollow Fountain tapped. So we get in before. Ooh, and Electricery. Hello. So we're just going to turn two pack rat it up and just randomly win with pack rat, maybe. That sounds like fun, doesn't it? I mean, he could have the... Azorius Charm here, but we're just going to... I guess the question is, it pitch lands? We never have to more than three lands, right? Yeah, I'm just going to pitch lands here. I don't see why not. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm crazy. Sealer Secrets. I think we just attack here, right? Pitcher. Okay. All right, so we're just going to go into game three here. The electric rees seem like they'll be useful, hopefully. Dino Charge is sick with Pack Rat, but I think this is a game that we're just going to win. Pretty straight up. Ooh, this hand is really good if I get a land. Really bad if I don't. This is the risk of a century here. Oh, these Deven Glees are really bad. I probably should have taken them out. God, do I keep this hand? All right, so I have 16 lands, so 15 cards. So chances of me getting it, so 15 out of 33, a little bit less than 50% chance of drawing it next. And then again, talk about being all in. I'm on the draw. I'm on the draw. I just need one land to make this a great hand. Two lands to make it a killer hand. Please be a land. Whew. Like a friggin' champ, eh? Yeah, we're going to go Rakdos Cackler first, followed by Shred Freak, maybe, if he doesn't drop a turn two play. Maybe even if he does. Apparition's okay. And we got Hellhole Flailer, which we can put Deviant Glee on to make him big and scary. And getting another land was actually pretty key there. Sure. And now his Keening Apparition's gone. I actually definitely attacked into it because I want Deviant Glee to stick. Him not having land sucks for him, but was pretty awesome for me. Because we're getting Hellhole. We're getting Hellhole all up in here. Yeah. Shebang, shebang. So, no land for him? Okay, this is basic... Oh, four lands, too. This is basically over. I mean, I have a couple options. I could swing in for six, drop a Gore House. Actually, you know what? I'm going to... swing in for eight... with the ability to blow for six later. I'm going to drop Gorehouse Chainwalker and say go. And this should be it. I mean, he could have bounce or something, but that's not that big of a deal. And arrest would be kind of a big deal, but whatever. Anyways, I won. So MVP is obviously Pack Rat. I won like half my games. That's disgusting. I feel actually pretty dirty, as you should when you play with rats. Whatever. Underworld Dreams got me there too. Definitely a pick that you put into an aggressive deck as the one piece of card advantage that gets you back in there. Those were the two big cards. So this is definitely, I would say this draft really showed that the two drop, the one drop, two drop is way more important than the three drop. My three drops were meh, you know, meh. Like Hellhole Flailer is awesome. This guy's pretty good. But really, it was that I could consistently get two drops so I could run 16 land and just turn after turn after turn, I always had a play that was aggressive. Anyways, Rakdos, pretty awesome. Thanks for watching, and see you on the other side.